put it in your DM.
Oh, thank you.
All right, that was The Pretender by the Foo Fighters. Thomas Quinlan from London, happy Turkey Day.
Happy Thanksgiving. Thank you for having me.
All right, let's tell a story.
Okay.
Start at the beginning. Tell us all the juicy parts.
Sure. Well, I'm not from London. I've been living here for about 8 years now. I'm originally from New York. I grew up there. I've had quite a few places to live over my time. I've lived in New York. I've lived in California. I lived in Rhode Island for some summers. I lived in Virginia for a little while. I decided at one point to write a book, and I didn't quite know what to write. And so I consulted with some friends, and they always say, write what you know. So I figured, what's the one thing I know the most about? And that's myself. So it was a bit egotistical in a way, but I thought it might be fun. So
what was the book called?
It's called Adventures in Cybersecurity, actually. So it is a biography, and I took about a year, actually, of evenings and weekends typewriting to finish the book, and basically tells the story of my life. And one of the interesting things from the very beginning is sort of, I was discussing the idea with a coworker at one point, and the coworker said, no offense, but why would anybody want to read about you? And he had a fairly decent point, but I wanted to go through the exercise. So
fuck that coworker. Your life is as interesting as anybody else's.
And that's kind of what I told him too.
Do you know that God created everything individually? There's something unique or different about every one of us.
Exactly.
So, all right. Yeah. So you're in cybersecurity, you write this book. Tell me three juicy things that are in the book. Okay. The night you went streaking down London.
Not quite that juicy. A lot of it has to do with the various fun things that I did or had happened to me. So when I was working at a very large accounting firm, one of the big four back in the day, we ran a service desk. And this was in the early 2000s timeframe, and just having people come to the service desk for various computer problems, all sorts of crazy stuff we saw. Like one lady told us her keyboard wasn't working. So the first thing we usually do with the keyboard was flip it upside down just to blow it out with some compressed air, and all her toenails kind of fell out of the keyboard.
Oh, oh no. Whoa.
Yeah. We had people come in with melted ants.
Wait a second, hold on. When was she standing near you when that happened?
Yes. Yeah. She didn't put two and two together, or she was
okay, wait a second. What did you say to her when you saw all those toenails?
You kind of can't say very much.
You can say all kinds of stuff.
You can say, what is this? And she said, yeah, I was clipping my toenails. I didn't think they'd gotten into the keyboard.
Oh, God.
So I was like, okay. Wait a second.
Was she hot or not?
Not. So.
Yeah, that makes the story even more perfect. Have you ever seen that movie Wanted?
No, I don't think so.
The kid whose father like tries to,
with Liam Neeson.
No. Yeah, with Liam. Okay. No, it's Angelina Jolie was in it. It was an action film. It's a great movie, but there's a film part in there. Oh my God, I gotta do it. I gotta do it. Hold on, I gotta find this for you. This will blow your mind. So what you're describing is a scene from the movie Wanted.
Hey, okay.
Get away from my food. Jesse's
dog wants some pie.
Yeah, he's like, yo, Dad, while you're not looking, I'm going to eat that banana bread because it looks delish. Wanted office scene. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Okay. This shit's going to blow your mind. All right. When you tell me this story, this is what's in my head right now. And okay. It's a classic scene. I know YouTube's going to be like, what the fuck? You can't do this shit. If you haven't seen this movie, there's a reason to see it now.
Okay.
You don't have my billing reports, but you've got time.
By the way, you're the guy in Wanted, and she's the one with the toenails.
I still don't have my billing reports, but you've got time to sit here and Google your ass off. Well, I know one thing. You've got your review coming up next week, and I can't wait to start checking me off some big fucking boxes. Or performance. Or management skills. Or works well with others. That's a fucking joke. What is this bullshit? Who's this prick? Some loser gets his head blown off. Shut the fuck up!
This is a classic line.
She has one single iota of tenuous power. She thinks she can push everyone around? You don't need this. I understand. Junior high must have been kind of tough, but it doesn't give you the right to treat your workers like horseshit, Janice. I know we laugh at you, Janice. We all know you keep a stash of jelly donuts in the top drawer of your desk. I want you to know, if you weren't such a bitch, I'd feel sorry for you. I do feel sorry for you. But as it stands, when you behave, I feel I can speak for the entire office. When I tell you, go fuck yourself.
There's the keyboard. Now, this is a classic scene. Watch this.
Yeah, it's great, bro. Who's the man?
Watch the letter.
The man.
Who's the man, Thomas?
Wow, that's quite a scene.
So when you're going like this with the can of air and you're cleaning out the keyboard, I'm imagining that lady is the lady standing next to you, and you're taking that keyboard and just jamming it across her face going, don't clip your toenails. Who's the man? I'm the man, Thomas Quinlan.
Yeah, I probably would have gotten fired right away.
I'm almost sure in that scene he didn't care about getting fired anymore.
Right, of course. But
all right, so that's actually a pretty good one. Toenails in the keyboard. I'll be honest, 100%, I have to say something smartass at that moment. Like, you almost have to just say, you're obligated to look at her and say, you fucking clip your toenails over your keyboard? Who the fuck does?
Well, she was apparently reading something.
I don't even think I can get my foot above the desk enough to actually clip over the keyboard.
I was just so shocked and quite frankly, kind of disgusted. I didn't really want
to
keep her around for as long as I just get away kind of thing. It was just a visceral reaction.
Now, in all honesty, was it just like one toenail? Because that I could live with. But like, was it like flecks of a bunch of toenails?
Yeah, it was. I mean, it was fairly obvious. There was like little pieces, but then there was like a couple that were obvious toenails. And
were they painted?
Yeah.
Oh, it's even worse.
Yeah, it was.
All right, for anybody watching this, don't do that. That is some grotesque shit.
Yeah, and that was just one example. I mean, we had people. One lady spilled olive oil on her keyboard because she was using her keyboard or using her computer to read recipes, and she had it on the stove. Another person took his laptop on a picnic. Had ants climb in. They all melted.
What is that? You had some serious outdoors cookie type people in your company.
Yeah.
This had to be back in the day when people were like, you know, I can't even imagine using it. Like, were these on laptops or were these on desktops?
No, they were all pretty, well, most of them were laptops. There were a couple of desktops. We had one lady come in with a desktop. She had like 2 inches of dust and feathers in her computer, and that was why it stopped working. So, well, she had a lot of birds, apparently.
Oh my God. Like, I'll be honest with you. When we set this up, you're like, oh, well, you know, who wants to hear my story and blah, blah, blah. You're crushing it in the first 15 minutes. Like, there's never been a story like this told on YouTube ever.
Well, I guess it means people should probably read a book, but.
That is true. How's the book doing, by the way?
Not too bad. I'm not going to be retiring anytime soon, but it gets here and there. So.
See, you should have put, somebody with a wand in the book too. And then named him, what the hell was J.K. Rowling's?
Harry Potter.
Call him Tommy Potter, you know. The Adventures of Tommy Potter inside the cyber world of toenail clippings and bird feathers.
Yeah.
Dude, you should have put that on the cover of the book. Literally a big old ass keyboard with toenail clippings falling out of it. That picture alone sells a million copies.
Or zero. I wasn't quite sure which. So, yeah.
All right. So you wrote the book. Oh, how's London, by the way? I have some friends in London. What the fuck is with the fucking mask police and the personal freedoms? What the fuck?
Yeah, it's not as bad as it's made out to be in the news. Obviously, we don't quite have the same constitutional republic mindset of the United States. There's no basis in freedom here. We have a long history of law and things like that, but it's not nearly as bad as people make it out to be. So, I mean, for the most part, things are pretty much the same. Where I live is very similar to New York City, for instance. The biggest differences are the money and the plugs are weirdly shaped, but
yeah,
pretty much the same thing.
Yeah, when I travel internationally, I have this like contraption that allows me to plug into like, seriously, what the fuck? How does the world not have a universal outlet? Like, seriously.
Good question.
Why does fucking Europe and other parts of Spain have to have a fucked up different outlet?
Well, the other crazy part about that is that the actual voltage is different too. So
what's the
So here it's 240 or yeah.
I'll be honest with you. I was always wondering about that because when I charged my shit in Malta one time, mm-hmm. I fucked up my laptop and I always thought to myself, it had to be the fucking electricity.
Yeah. That's exactly right.
European electricity.
Yeah, in the US it's 110 and 120. Here it's 220 and 240. So the voltage is essentially double. Nowadays, those contraptions typically
will... Fuck, I electrocuted my laptop. Rest in peace, MacBook.
Yeah, most of the time, they're supposed to. I mean, I don't have the plug handy, but actually, I do. Come think about it. But this thing in the plug is supposed to regulate the voltage for you.
Uh-huh.
But if it doesn't work properly, then you can kiss your laptop goodbye kind of thing. So.
Wow, the shit I'm learning. All right, so... You're in London now. It ain't as bad as it looks on TV. Could always get worse. You never know. Give them an inch, they'll take a mile. You know, it's crazy. Have you like said to yourself, 2020 seems really weird in a weird way, but it almost seems like these politicians had a plan. Like a lot of this shit seems to be falling all in line with what politicians want.
Yes. Yeah. And there's quite a bit that you can check out online and various other things. You know, lots of rabbit holes to go down there and
read The Great Reset at the World Economic Have you read it?
I was just about to say there's The Great Reset for people to research things like that. So,
watch Bill Gates. I think it's his TED Talk where he talks about reducing the population.
Yeah, there's actually I'd have to find it, but there's a really really, really long article that somebody wrote about Bill Gates. I mean, like, if you scroll, it takes a good minute just to scroll to the bottom, even if you don't read it. It's absurdly long. It's like a book in one web page. I'd have to go through Evernote to find it again, but it's quite interesting. I read maybe the first four or five screens, and yeah.
Yeah, I got to say that if the most powerful people in the world got together in a room, let's say Davos, and they wanted to create the greatest distribution of wealth we've ever seen in our time, and they worked with major country leaders, I don't know, like Xi Jinping. Is it Xi Jinping? It's almost like the people that are in control of, I don't know, let's say Amazon, the evil empire. When is, by the way, are you aware of any due date for Amazon to build the Death Star?
No, I can't say that I am. Wouldn't put it past them at this point, potentially. So
I'll be honest with you. That has to be on their list of things to do. Great distribution of wealth, buy Whole Foods, build Death Star.
Well, he already has a space company, Blue Origin, so he's Blue on Origin, track.
That's what I was thinking. I'm like, what's Blue Origin designed to do? Build Death Star. if Bezos is Darth Vader, which, by the way, we have no proof linking to Jeff Bezos to Darth Vader, but we do have a call into his ex-wife, Mackenzie. She may be able to verify a few things. By the way, is Jeff Bezos' ex-wife the hottest, most eligible woman on the planet right now?
Could well be.
I mean, she literally has taken her net worth to like over $100
billion. Yeah.
In this pandemic with her stock.
Yeah, that stock price has been absolutely insane. Just, well, I mean,
you think about it, they're crushing all the small businesses, and you're literally reduced to getting all your shit from fucking Amazon.
Yeah, that's true.
It's like they planned it this way.
Well, it was, I tweeted, I guess maybe a few weeks ago, there was one day where I think Jeff Bezos with the stock price made like $140 billion in a day or something. It was ridiculous. It was literally greater than the GDP of 49 countries.
Couldn't have been 140 billion.
Well, it's like 14 or something. It was
14 billion, I can believe. But like his total net worth, I think it's like 170 billion.
Okay, so yeah, sorry.
You could say 14. And even 14 is a big number.
Like right.
I could see maybe 1.4.
The number was bigger than the yearly GDP of the bottom 49 countries on whatever list it is that they rank those countries. It was literally more than the yearly GDP of 49 countries in a single day.
And I don't know if people are literally falling asleep at the wheel or not paying attention, but economically what's happening in the world is god awful horrific. I don't know what's happening out in London, but here in the States, restaurant owners are getting devastated.
Same here.
And I literally saw a video today in Canada. They, in handcuffs, walked this guy away from his restaurant because he opened against like some sort of mask rule or whatever. I don't know, some sort of rule that they had. And they literally, they arrested a restaurant owner because he opened his business, because he pursued his dream. Now, I got to say, that just is not right. Like there's shit that's happening that is just not right. I mean, if God or aliens came to this planet, I'm almost sure they would say, listen, we run our country or our world or our planet a little differently. You guys are running it like pretty fucked up right now. I saw a kid in Australia get dragged out of a mall the other day and like by a cop for not wearing a mask, and they literally knocked him unconscious. I'm like,
I saw that.
For a mask? A fucking mask?
I saw a video of a man wearing a mask who was arrested because his son was not wearing one. Just
now, I'm going to tell you something. When you're in cybersecurity, and I've been in digital security for a long time, cryptocurrencies, I tell people, don't use your real name on the internet. Come up with a pseudonym. My real name is not Chris Champion. It is Chris. But when people get a little bit of information about you, I've had my my personal identity hacked 4 times, probably because they wanted to get access to accounts that they tried to. One case, they got 21 BTC for me. So that was hats off to those guys. That was very Yeah, but that was a long time ago when BTC was worth shit. But now I'm like, what the fuck, please? I wish I had those. Probably would have sold them anyhow. So I can sleep better thinking that. But if you're not careful, the world can change your life in a heartbeat just by being not aware of your personal security. What are some of the things that you would tell people about personal security?
So first and foremost, as you say, you do have to be aware of your identity. So the things you post online, for starters, that stuff never goes away. Even if you think it does, even if you delete it, even if you try to get rid of it, even if you hire external firms to try and get rid of that stuff, it never goes away.
Well, isn't there like a site that stores everything on Twitter? I think there's a site that stores everything on Twitter.
Yep, exactly.
Like, if you tweet it and then make a typo or forget, want to delete it right away, the second you tweet it, it actually snaps it up, stores it in a database, and it's like there forever.
And that's assuming there are no government backups and that sort of thing, because obviously they do quite a bit of that. Literally, all they do is suck that stuff up and keep it forever.
All right, so I got to ask you, is Edward Snowden a motherfucking hero?
Yes.
Why? So,
essentially, because he brought to the fore what people already suspected and actually was able to show proof of. So it's one thing to say, oh, the government's stealing all our information, or the government's spying on its own citizens, or what have you. It's another thing entirely to be able to prove it. And that's essentially what he did. He was able to prove it. He was able to show that these programs exist and that they were being used unlawfully against the citizens of the US. And at the time that, well, it still includes me. I'm still a citizen of the US. So they tend to get around that now by doing things like having other governments potentially look at things on U.S. soil and vice versa.
Did you ever see Jesse James in action? Jesse, it's time for a cameo. Say hi to Tom. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, hi, I give you Jesse James, the greatest cybersecurity dog ever. His entire online profile has been wiped clean. Not really.
Well, never. Ever clip his toenails over a computer.
Oh, God, back to the quote. I'll be honest with you. Seriously, you crushed it with the toenail story. If you were going to lead with a good walk-up song, which, by the way, good walk-up song. But
thank
the
you.
Story, I mean, the toenail story. And by the way, did you see the connection with that wanted clip?
Yes, like, absolutely.
Bring back memories. Did she look a little bit like that lady?
She didn't have red hair, and she wasn't quite the same age. She was actually a little older, but yeah,
same physical body structure probably.
Yes. Yeah,
see, I when you were telling the story, I had her in mind, and I thought to myself, I bet you she had a fucking little stapler in her hand when she was going, hey, those aren't my toenails.
No, but I bet you had a toenail clipper in her bag. So
yeah, I gotta tell you, feet are an interesting thing. Like, I know, like, they're important. Obviously, you can't walk without them. And, you know, women are all funky about their toenails and stuff. Oh, look at this. Jesse decided to bring in, we've got a cameo now from Jesse's former bull. This used to be a bull, and now it's barely a squeaky toy. All right, buddy, go get it. So I always think to myself, too, when people are in that situation, when she was standing there next to you, she had to realize, I gotta take better care of my personal hygiene away from my electronics.
Hopefully. Yeah, I basically never ran into her again. I'm pretty sure she was mortified. So yeah, it was presumably not something
like crossing each other's path on the sidewalk one day. You gotta be like, oh, hey, look in the sky.
Yes. Yeah. It's the kind of person you generally avoid in the hallways and at the cafeteria and things like that. So,
all right. So you wrote the book. You're in London. Married, kids, dogs, puppies?
Married with one son.
Oh, congrats. What's his name? Or no, we don't have
Maxwell.
How old is he now?
He's 5.
Oh, my God. You're past the part where you can actually sleep now. And yep, he can poop on his own. He's got the whole pooping and peeing down, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Here's where it's like, okay, it's not too bad. And then in a couple of years, it'll be insane. But boys are actually less insane than women. Like, you
as I understand
it. Like, first of all, did you know that little girls are 3 times more expensive than a boy?
No, I didn't.
Yeah. Their clothes cost 3 times as much more. Their needs are 3 times as much more. They need more hair care products. They need more stuff. Even their socks are 3 times as much more.
Wow.
I know. Like, they don't buy white socks. They buy like colored Nike socks, like $14 socks instead of like the Costco $1 socks or whatever they are.
Guess I never really looked into it.
So you lucked out. You got a boy. He'll probably drive you a little nuts down the road. By the way, tell the son one day when he gets a little older, the toenail story. 100% sure. When he has to go to school and, hey, what does your dad do for a living? You motherfuckers are never going to believe this.
Yeah. He's actually started asking me to teach him about computers. So,
oh, please.
The cycle seems to be,
do me a favor. Teach him about Bitcoin.
Yeah. We actually make a fairly regular habit of checking my crypto portfolio already. So,
okay. So what's in your crypto? Bitcoin?
Bitcoin, Ethereum. Dash, Tezos.
Dash has the best marketing structure of any coin. They were like literally structured to be successful long-term because they set aside money to actually run a business behind it.
Exactly. Yeah. I have lots of really little weird coins like UpToken and Verge and Monero V. And I actually have regular Monero as well.
I fucking love Monero. If Satoshi was alive today, I'm 100% sure he would say that Monero is what he wanted Bitcoin to become.
Yep.
He was more concerned about privacy than anything else. And somewhere, Bitcoin forgot about privacy, but Monero actually woke up and said, we'll fix that.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know, it's funny. You see where our buddy Steven Mnuchin, he wants to make decentralized wallets not a thing anymore. He wants to try and ban him.
Yeah, he'll have a hard time of doing that. So,
well, I don't know if he'll have a hard time of doing it. Put it this way. I think it'll be impossible to ban him entirely because you can always have Web3 or, you know, some other kind of access. But here's what he will do. He'll make it so that you can't put him on your iPhone or your Android easily. Now, definitely not iPhone easily because Apple is such a fucking tight-knit group, but Android, you could probably get it on there through, you know, an APK file.
Yeah. And then there's other operating systems for the really adventurous, but most people don't jailbreak and or change the operating system on their phone. So
have you looked at some of the phones that are highly secure phones, like the actual hardware phones, like I think it's called Black Signal, or have you ever looked at some of those phones?
I did briefly. I actually know a guy who was the CTO of, I think it's that company, actually.
I don't think it's Black Signal, but it's something like that. It's like, I want to say Signal or something. No, Signal.
Yes. Signal's the app. It's similar to Telegram or what have you.
Black
it does the encryption.
The Black. Definitely wasn't BlackBerry.
No. Yeah, there's a...
Is BlackBerry still around? Did they die?
No, they're still around. They actually purchased.
If those motherfuckers were smart, they would build the greatest secure phone in the history of mankind.
They purchased a company that you would never think that they would purchase. And they, they're still around.
How do they even have enough money to purchase anything?
That's a good question. Silent Circle.
Silent Circle. That's it. Yep.
Yep.
So, like, seriously, who the fuck is buying a BlackBerry these days?
Actually, I know two people that still have BlackBerries and they absolutely swear by them. So we all make fun of them, but they swear by them. So,
well, I get that. And, you know, BlackBerry back in the day had its like ups and downs, but think about this for a second. Who the fuck's buying a new BlackBerry? Like there's no face chat or there's no FaceTime.
Well, they run Android now. So,
oh, do they?
Yeah.
Do they have like a flat screen Android? Do they have like an updated version? Because when I think of BlackBerry, I think of that fucked up QWERTY keyboard.
And that's the selling point for the people that I know that still have them. It's the fact that they don't want to live without that physical keyboard. And so they keep buying BlackBerries.
I'll be honest with you. That physical keyboard had its day. Like, I actually kind of like QWERTY. You know that was the name of the keyboard, right? QWERTY?
Yep.
I actually think of when I used to hear the word QWERTY. You ever hear of that game, Qbert?
Yes.
And yeah. That Qbert game had the best music. Do you remember that music?
Yes.
Like I don't know what, I can't tell you the song if I had to right now, but the Qbert song was the bomb.
Yeah. You kind of have to wonder what the people who made it were on at the time they made it, but
yeah.
It was a really cool game. I used to play that quite a bit on the Atari 5200, actually.
Holy wow. How old are you?
45.
I was going to say, it is just like dated.
Boop, 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 boop. And you can never go straight. You always had to go sideways.
Yeah, you can never go backwards. How's that?
Yeah.
The backwards thing was like a big screw up too. So you got a kid, you're in cybersecurity.
Yep.
What's your roadmap? Are you going to write another book? You should just write a book about the fucking toenail lady. That alone.
Well, it's in the existing one. And I was thinking about adding to this one or making a version 2 kind of thing.
Can I tell you what you should write? And this would be a big seller.
Sure.
Teach people basic cybersecurity tips. I know so many people that have horrible cybersecurity tips. Like, just teach people how to do 2FA on your Gmail account. Like, just do that. I know so many people that don't protect their own email accounts. I'm like, dude, that's how like they get all your shit.
Or they use the same password for everything, which is probably the biggest thing not to do.
All right, excuse me. I got to write down a little personal note. Change some of my passwords. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, a password manager nowadays is probably the easiest thing you can do, because even if you don't want to use the suggested password, because the suggested passwords always end up being like parentheses, spacebar, shift 3 kind of stuff. You can make up your own passwords and keep them in the password manager, because by the time you're my age, you have like 1,000 passwords for things, and it's virtually impossible to remember them all, no matter how good your memory is.
I actually give all my good passwords to Jesse, and when I really need something, I ask him, Jesse, give me the password. Give me my 256 character crypto key to my Bitcoin wallet.
God. Bark.
If I ever lost my Bitcoin crypto keys, I would cry. Which, by the way, here's a great tip. You want to store your keys, put half the key in one spot and the other half of the key in another spot. And this way, no matter what, you're the only one that knows how to connect the two.
Exactly. Yeah, that's a very good tip, actually.
Yeah. So. And by the way, the Holy Bible is still a good resting place for all your security tools. if somebody went to rob my house, all they'd have to do is go straight for the Holy Bible.
What they don't know, though, is that it's actually a book cipher and it points you somewhere else. So
that, oh, all my
secure.
If I actually wanted to lose my shit and really like put people on a rabbit hunt, I'd be like, yeah, you must be a big fan. Tom Hanks? What were those movies?
The Da Vinci Code?
You must be a big fan of Da Vinci Code.
Yeah, I love the book, actually. The movie was a little wanting compared to the book, as many movies often are, but the book was great.
I get that, but the movie at least got people like to understand how to decipher things. Like everything you see in front of you is not exactly what you see in front of you. Right. And that's the one thing that that cryptography and cyber science teaches you is what you see is not always what you're looking at.
Exactly. And then when you watch things like television or the news or movies, all of those things, it's probably one of the most important lessons I learned when I was in high school is that all of that stuff is completely staged. Everything you see when you watch a movie, when you watch television, when you watch the news, somebody made a conscious choice to put whatever it is that you're looking at, where it was in that particular scene at that particular time.
Shout out to the weirdos at the BBC and CNN who don't even practice journalism anymore.
No.
All right, so answer this. Since you just opened up that rabbit hole, let's go full down it. Who is the motherfucker that's creating the narrative? There's got to be like a limited number of motherfuckers, and they've got to be spending serious cheddar to keep these institutions alive.
Well, I think it was George Carlin who basically said that it doesn't even have to be sort of a grand conspiracy theory, even of a small amount of people. It's just there are a group of people who have more resources than you and I potentially ever will, even combined, and they have interests.
Death Star General Jeff Bezos.
They have interests that pretty much align. So as long as they're working in their interests and they know this group of people, they're pretty much all aligned. And so it sort of just happens as a natural way of things. It's not even like they have to get together and have secret meetings with cloaks and candles and things like that.
Oh, they have secret. It's called Davos, by the way, just for the record. If you guys ever want to go crash the Darth Vader evil meeting group, could just go to Davos. It's in one of those private rooms. It's usually the room that has at least a few centurions in front of them with a lion going across.
That was a good show.
Actually, in the world we live in today, I think Elon Musk is Luke Skywalker and Jeff Bezos is the Sith Lord who's building the Death Star. I actually say to myself, it's almost playing out exactly the way it should.
And they're sitting next to each other on the Forbes billionaire list now. So
I think Elon is passing everybody. I know he passed. Did he pass Warren Buffett the other day?
He passed Bill Gates yesterday or the day before, and he's now the second richest person on earth.
Who's first? Bezos?
Yeah.
Fuck. Get him, Luke. Get him. You didn't think we were going to go down the rabbit hole on this talk, before, did you?
Oh, that's fine.
Obviously, haven't followed some of my tweets. All right, so we covered crypto. We covered the Death Star. We've covered the.
I didn't even finish on the crypto. The two biggest ones I have now are Celsius and Matic. So
Celsius has been on a motherfucking run.
Yes. Yeah. I actually started with that in 2018. So I got really lucky. I started buying it at around 5 cents. As of now, it's like 250 something, or actually I think it's down to about $2. But yeah, it's been quite nice, that one.
You know, it's kind of weird. Alex, the guy that runs Celsius, I always thought to myself there was something sketchy about him, but I got to give him credit where credit is due. He is crushing it like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
He's got a little hate for the guys over at BlockFi, though. He's like all kinds of pissy about them. They get more publicity than I do. Well, maybe it's because you're just not that entertaining. I'll get a tattoo on the side of your face. I guarantee you people start putting you on their podcast. Can you imagine Alex getting a Mike Tyson tattoo? No.
Definitely not his style.
Well, Alex, you want some publicity, get the motherfucking tattoo. 100%, you're all over the news.
But I think eventually people will have to have him on because the company is just going to explode. They had an A round on Bank to the Future, which was at a valuation of 120 million. And I'm pretty sure they just hit a billion in terms of their valuation. So it's basically 8X since then.
Was
and that, that
was
only,
that a security or was that a token they sold?
It was shares in the company. So security.
where are they out of? Are they UK or US?
They're actually headquartered here in London, I believe. Yeah. And then Alex and his crew are in New York. They have a bunch of people in Israel, a bunch of people in Serbia. And I believe they're hiring. So technically, I think people are looking for jobs. They got like 50 slots open or something, and it doesn't really matter where you are, as I understand it. So,
have you been able to stake your Celsius? You can stake Celsius, right?
Yes. Yeah. Good part about being here and being a dual citizen is that I'm a dual citizen. So I have the two passports, two addresses. I can pick and choose.
Pick and choose what? Tax purposes?
Well, no, actually, it's the one thing I can't choose, but I can choose which identity effectively to use for KYC AML. I probably shouldn't be talking about this, but so when I sign up for crypto things,
it's the same.
I sign up.
It like leads to the same human being.
Yeah, but for instance, United States citizens can't currently earn Celsius, or couldn't up until very recently. And even now that they can, they have to be an accredited investor.
What?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. And so if I were to have signed up for Celsius using my US address, then I wouldn't have been able to earn and sell. But since I have a London address, obviously, I use that one to sign up for Celsius, and then I can earn and sell. So
I did not know this. This is interesting shit. Just when I think I know everything. What happened to crypto last night? Did Mnuchin drop the market low enough so that he could buy some fucking cheap coins?
Well, I seem to recall that this happened the same time last year and roughly the same magnitude, because people sell crypto in advance of Black Friday so that they can go and spend all their money on stuff they don't need.
I'm almost sure it has nothing to do with Black Friday. If it is, there's a lot of motherfucking people in crypto buying like Lambos this weekend. Is there even a Black Friday sale on Lamborghinis?
Wouldn't think so.
This Friday and this Friday only, Lamborghini, 20% off the entire inventory. You know, I got to say, the whole Black Friday, Black Monday thing, the ads are getting pretty fucking insane. Like, I got a friend of mine right now. He's sleeping in the frigid cold weather of North Carolina in front of a GameStop. He's third in line because they're selling a PS5 for $500 that has a retail price tag of $240, and he wants to buy it so he can flip it for $1,100 online. What the fuck, people? Wait till February. They'll be $249.
Yep.
Like, I see people online literally losing their shit for these PS5s.
I didn't even know it was out, to be honest.
Oh, you haven't seen the insanity over this thing?
I block ads and I don't watch television, to be honest. So
I got to tell you, you're missing out on some crazy shit. The new PS5, I'm not kidding you, people are selling kidneys to buy this fucking thing. Like, wow. There's a limited supply. You would think that they were buying crack cocaine. Like, they're literally losing their shit. They're paying exorbitant amount of money for a video game player.
Wow.
Which I'm almost sure the older PS5 still works all the games, like, you know, pretty much the same way.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Maybe the new one has a faster chip or better graphics card. Like, the shit that people do for fucking electronics. I'm like, dude, don't you know in a year this shit's going to be obsolete? By the way, shout out to Apple. When you came out with your new phone, all of a sudden my old phone now acts like shit. So fuck you very much, Tim Cook. And I know you motherfuckers are fucking with my battery too.
Actually, I thought there was some kind of lawsuit or something about that.
Yeah.
Recently settled.
100% that they're motherfuckers. Hey, 12 just came out. By the way, any of you motherfuckers that still have the iPhone 3, that shit's not going to work.
No.
People will be like, what the fuck? What's going on here?
Well, at least they have copy and paste. So
we got almost had a cameo appearance there for a second. So another cyber sleuth that I know, his name is Laren. He's just chiming in. So Like, oh my God. He's like, oh my God, I want to talk to this guy. When I ask him about the girl with the toenails. Yo.
There we go.
Yeah. So, hey, say hello to Thomas.
Hello.
Thomas is a cyber sleuth. He bought some pretty good cryptos back in the day. Got himself some Celsius at some primo prices.
Nice.
Yeah. We're doing a podcast right now, and I didn't want to interrupt your Thanksgiving. Are you eating yet? Have you attacked?
We're not even, we're still cooking and shit. You want to come out here?
No, I got podcasts and I got shit to do, but I'll call you back in a little bit when the whole world's not watching. Say goodbye to Thomas.
Bye. Nice to meet you.
So, it's been an interesting talk. Like, what you said was going to be not that interesting. I'll be honest with you. We've hit some fucking good target points.
Thank you.
Yes, so what's your roadmap? What does your life look like for the next 6, 12, 18 months? Make another baby?
Well, yeah, I'm going to definitely keep going on the Celsius stuff. That's no question. Probably going to move, not like out of the city or anything, to a different place. Going to buy a place. And then keep working.
Celsius cheddar?
Maybe. So actually, you don't even...
Get something with a moat and some crocodiles around it.
Or something that's enough floors up that I don't have to worry. But yeah, you don't even have to use the Celsius. You can just borrow against it, which is really nice. So
that is true. Who lends against it? Celsius?
Celsius themselves, yeah.
Yeah, so. I've always thought to myself, who the fuck is borrowing the money that allows them to make these margins? And I thought to myself, you know, it's people that don't want to fucking take the capital gains hit and want to buy shit.
Yep. Exactly. And Alex actually has a video, I think, where he explains all that. The thing that I never understood, once I figured that out from watching the video, is why are they using Matic? Matic pays 21.49% if you earn and sell. And that's a crazy interest rate. And I'm thankful for it and I'm going to keep doing it, but I don't understand why they're using Matic. So I probably could do some more research on the token. I know a little bit about it.
I'll be honest with you. Some of these interest rates that they pay out on some of these coins, I'm not a mathematical genius by any means, but I definitely am kind of. Where the fuck do they get those numbers from?
I presume it's, well, if they're to be believed, it's the 80% of what they're charging, whomever they're charging. So they've got to be charging somebody 23-24% to be borrowing Matic. So they keep the 20%.
Paying that kind of interest rate to borrow Matic.
That's my question too. But
is Matic in the meth industry? Because that's the only industry where you would pay 25% to fucking borrow money that you could use to do something.
Somebody out there is doing something crazy with Matic and some kind of derivative or something that's just going to be either wonderfully fantastic for them or terribly tragic. And in the meantime, benefits us. So
what about all the DeFi crazy shit that's happening?
That's something I sort of looked into. One of the other small coins that I've held for quite some time is Indorse. And so I had like almost 200,000 of them. And so I actually tried being a liquidity provider on Uniswap. And right now I'm pretty much the only person outside of the Indorse folks to have Indorse on Uniswap. So
and
if you actually
Indorse.
So it's effectively sort of a skills share or freelance hiring site like Odesk or.
Oh, by the way, we're going to take a 2-minute break. Hold on 1 second.
Okay.
Well, not quite the whole 2 minutes.
When you're single, it's Thanksgiving, and you've got a 12-inch chicken pot pie in the oven, and it says keep it in there for an hour, and you realize, holy fuck, it's been an hour and 30 minutes.
Oh, hopefully it's okay.
Yeah, actually, surprisingly, I was expecting a nice charred black cover, but I think the whole preheat to 375, I just jammed that baby in right away. So I think I bought myself 20 minutes.
That makes a difference, yes.
Yeah, I'm sitting there looking at my phone. I'm like, oh, it's 2:00. I'm like, hey, you put that pie in at 12:30. It's set for an hour. I'm like, oh my God. By the way, chicken pot pie. Mm-hmm. It's fucking motherfucking bomb. You put some cheddar cheese on top of that.
I'm getting all hungry and it's 10 o'clock at night here.
Exactly. I'm keeping you up. So we were talking crypto, which is always fun to talk about.
Yep.
Name three things that you enjoy personally in your life. Can be any three things. Chicken pot pie. Okay.
Chicken pot pie. Well, crypto is obviously a big one. And then I enjoy spending time with my son, teaching him. That's quite rewarding, actually. He's a fantastic little guy. That goes also spending time with my wife. I'll lump those together so that we don't have to. And then I have to think of a third one.
How'd you meet?
I enjoy exercise.
Yeah, give me a good wife story. How'd you meet her?
We met through a mutual friend in Washington, D.C. I was living in Virginia at the time. Yeah,
so when you got set up and you first met her, were you like, hubba, hubba, hubba?
Yes. And we bonded over the television show Criminal Minds, of all things. So,
Criminal Minds? Why does that sound familiar? What was that about?
It's about the behavioral analysis unit of the FBI.
And so, oh, like CSI?
Essentially, yeah. It's one of those procedural cop type shows. So, but this one focuses sort of on serial killers and how they effectively use behavioral analysis to try and figure out who's doing what and save people.
So your future wife was into serial killer movies and you found that attractive?
Not exactly, but.
Honey, I think you're the girl for me. By the way, have you ever seen that movie, Dexter?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh my God. That guy was epic on every epic scale you could ever like imagine.
Anthony, what's the name of the Hall? I want to say Anthony Michael Hall, but I think that's the guy in The Breakfast Club.
Yeah, I was going to say that wasn't him. Wasn't he in Weird Science, by the way? By the way, greatest movie growing up as a high school male, Weird Science. It literally made every boy in high school realize, I want to figure out science so I can build a hot girl like that. Yes. By the way, who was the girl in Weird Science?
Kelly Brock.
Was it Kelly Brock?
Yeah.
Back in the day, hubba, hubba, hubba.
Yep. Michael C. Hall.
Yeah. Michael C. Wow, who was the kid in Weird Science? What was his name?
That's Anthony Michael Hall, I think.
Anthony Michael Hall.
I think. So,
right. I think you're right. Him and Kelly Brock. Wow.
And Bill Paxton.
If I created Kelly Brock in high school in my house, that would be the greatest book of all time. And by the way, she could clip her toenails all over the keyboard. All over the keyboard. I think she's actually limber enough to get her foot over the keyboard in order to clip her toes.
But probably when the movie was made.
Let's be honest. She's at the nail salon. She's got some girl going on her feet. She's one of those pretty feet girls.
Kelly LeBrock is her name, actually. I had it wrong.
Kelly LeBrock?
Yeah. And it is Anthony Michael Hall.
God, I would die to have her jump in right now with the call with us. Like, can you imagine her jumping in? Even now, she's probably hot as fuck.
I was gonna say it came out in 1985, so I was 10 at the time.
I don't know, I think I was like 18, 19, but I was like, yo, girl, how do I make you? These two kids made a supermodel.
After making a nuclear missile, as I recall. So
really?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure they also made, or they enlarged the nuclear missile. I mean, it was obviously the symbolism is fairly straightforward on that one, but yeah, it was some kind of ICBM missile or something that they, because it came up through the floor and out the roof of the house.
Oh, yeah. I kind of remember that now. Yeah. You remember that better. Oh, I just can only remember Kelly LeBron. All right. So here's the question. You're in London. You're a U.S. citizen. What are your thoughts on this fucking insane election we had this year? And I don't think it's over yet.
No, I don't think it will be over until probably December 15th. And I tend to think there will be a lot of very unhappy people on the Joe Biden side of things, because I never underestimate Mr. Trump. So,
well, it's actually funny because I'm writing a book about Trump called Trump Winning Mindset. And that motherfucker just wins. He wins. Now, by the way, just for the record, let me just share something with you, just from feet on the ground.
Okay.
Nobody that I've ever even talked to has voted for Joe Biden. And when Trump was filling like airport hangars with 50,000 people, this squad had like 12 people in fucking circles. Playing Twister. If anyone obviously had voter fraud to try and get the votes in, it was that guy.
Yeah.
I don't even think he's like even mentally fit for office. Like, he did a speech the other day and like he's just mentally gone. Like, he's fried. Like, the circuits are not connecting. He's got toenails in his clipboard.
He's 6 months younger than my mother, and she's in a retirement community, and he's trying to be president of the United States. And
well, he's had three strokes, and the guy is mentally, like, he's just not there.
Like, if he wins,
shit, that's just fucking like, hey, you know, the kids that played with the hairs on my leg. I'm like, what the fuck? And what is with him and sniffing hair?
That is the most disturbing thing. It's just, and there's like Paul Joseph Watson, I guess, put together a montage.
Shout
it's
out like to two Paul or three minutes long. One of the best. He's out in the UK, isn't he?
Yes. Yeah. He did a clip. It's like 3 minutes long. It's just nothing but that. And it's, if it were one thing, maybe sort of still wouldn't really be a thing you could excuse, but like a 3 minute clip, putting that all together.
If you had a small girl child, would you let Joe Biden babysit her?
Nope.
Like, what the fuck is with him and women between the ages of 12 and 26? Like, he is creepy fucking Joe. Like, he's just like, he does the weirdest fucking pedophilia, weird shit, like, touches them and like the hair. What the like, I don't have hair, so I think I'm fairly safe around Joe. I think you're pretty safe around Joe too.
Exactly.
But like, if I did have hair, like my friend Hotep Jesus, shout out to Hotep, he's got some serious dreadlocks. If Joe's anywhere near Hotep, I think he's like sneaking up behind Hotep and going, "Your dreads, buddy. Your dreads, they do something for me." So, I mean, you think about this shit and you're like, if there was ever a lame duck candidate, one that literally was never supposed to win, nobody ever believed he was supposed to win, and he supposedly got more votes than Obama, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, it's just so difficult to believe. It strains credulity in every sense of the word. And I mean, I know people who voted for Biden, but they all don't live in the United States. So they sent their mail-in votes, apparently, but it's like four people. So yeah, it's okay,
four. Not 80 million, four. Here's the other thing. You're in cybersecurity. Is there anything more open for fraud or stupidity than paper and people? Like, literally.
And those election machines. I mean, there are videos. Well, here's
the crazy thing. Take the fucking election machine and put the code, open source it on the blockchain.
Exactly.
Let anybody look at the code in real time. And then this way, you have a provably fair election.
Exactly. Yep.
But no, these fucking genius politics. By the way, I tell people this all the time. You know why you should buy Bitcoin? It's a bet against idiot politicians who should never be in charge of economic policy.
Exactly.
They're all greedy. They're all idiots. I got to give Trump credit. In his 4 years, he resisted a lot of fucking shit that the idiot politicians always try to do. By the way, this is the greatest cryptocurrency known to Jesse. Oh, he's got issues now. He's got issues now. So yeah. You got to give him credit. And here's the other thing I give him credit for. Shout out to Trumpy. He didn't get us over the four. He's the first president to not get us into a conflict.
Yeah.
I mean, what the fuck? We are always in some fucking conflict where we're trying to police something.
Yeah. And I saw an article the other day where, I guess, the gentleman who started, gentlemen and ladies, I suppose, who started serving in Afghanistan way back when in Iraq, their kids are now going to the same war. And that's just crazy.
Well, let's be honest. Fucking Afghanistan, get the fuck out of there. Buddy of mine serves over there, and he's an Army Corps of Engineer. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you an interesting story he told me a couple of years ago. I don't know if it's the same situation, but I'm going to assume it is. We would literally ship shit over there to build a hospital or a school. In the process of shipping these containers over there, the shit would fucking come there, and it'd be an empty container already. They'd rob you of the shit we were sending over there. So they had to like create this armed force of people to literally guard and secure the shit, to get the shit, to build the hospital. 2 weeks after the hospital or school was built, these motherfuckers would burn that shit down. And that shit's been going all on and on and on to the tune of trillions of dollars for 20 years. He's like, they don't even want us here. What the fuck are we here for?
Yeah. It's tragic, actually.
I'll tell you the secret. The industrial military complex. Fuck those motherfuckers. All they want to do is sell bullets and fucking gear.
Yep. Eisenhower warned us 60, 70 years ago.
What? So, what'd he say?
I think it was his last address as president. He basically said that we have to watch out for the military industrial complex. And this was 1958 or whatever. I don't know what. Ike stopped being president, but if you Google Eisenhower and military industrial complex, you'll get the whole speech. So
you know those motherfuckers absolutely wanted fucking Trumpy out of office.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I wouldn't be shocked if it all fucking comes to fruition that we find out that the corrupt CIA, which are fucking professional liars for a living, had something to do with all this fucking bullshit voter fraud. Like, there's zero chance that Trumpy is up 800,000 in Pennsylvania at, like, midnight. And then all of a sudden, well, we're going to stop the count. Just going to stop for a while. Everybody go home.
Don't look at the men.
Bring the trucks in the back door. We got to get those fucking Biden boxes in.
Don't look at these people over here.
At the Senate hearing, the one analyst guy who's a fucking former military, high-character individual, 600,000 votes tabulated during that time when they stopped counting. They brought in boxes and boxes of all these mail-in. You might as well just call them, you know, write-in votes. And 3,000 out of 600,000 were for Trumpy.
Yep.
Get the fuck out of here! Come on, man! Like, nobody believes that. Nobody believes that.
Except the people who want to. So.
Well, by the way, I've officially gotten this video censored. when people go to watch this video, there's going to be a big YouTube banner. The election was not fraud. Like, by the way, as a cyber person that knows a little bit about behind the scenes shit, was it shocking to you how horribly, and I got to find the right word, how horribly engaged Facebook and Twitter were in censoring everything along the way to the election?
It's not shocking at all, to be honest. So
it's not shocking, but it was kind of shocking to see it happening. Like, it was just so blatantly obvious. Like, they censored Trump 300,000 times and Biden zero. They literally censored Biden zero. He could have gone on there and said, my son Hunter has never done crack cocaine. But Twitter would have said, most fact checkers have found this to be true.
And the amazing part too is that the algorithms that they use are advanced enough to know even regarding pictures and things. So obviously when there's pictures and they have text in them, you can do OCR and you can get the text and things. But some of the pictures I've seen on things like Instagram, that they're actual pictures, they're just images, and it'll still say this is about the election and this may be disputed kind of thing. And I'm just like, wow, they spent a lot of time and effort to actually police all this stuff to the point where they've probably created some algorithms that would be better used for other things, and they're just wasting their time.
I mean, fucking Al-Qaeda and Iran, the Khomeini, he can tweet shit about fucking, you know, killing Israel and burning Americans alive at the stake, and no fucking censorship on that.
Yeah.
But Trump says, hey, the election was rigged. Whoa, fucking CNN says it wasn't. So fuck, don't like this shit. Like, I literally go to like Trump's tweets these days and like a big thing pops up. You sure you want to like this shit? Because this motherfucker's wrong. I'm like, yeah, man, I want to like this shit. All right, but we're just going to not have it show up as a like on your feed.
Exactly. So no matter what you do.
So if you were going to have a regime change coup, you'd need the social media companies involved. You'd somehow have to hack the software that was registering the votes, which, by the way, somebody said something interesting one day, a long time ago. He who counts the votes elects the president.
I care not who you vote for. I care only who counts the votes. Stalin, I think, said that.
Yeah probably. Yeah, shout out to Stalin. Oh, my God. And here's the crazy thing. They're not only blatant about it, but they're now literally so blatant that they said, fuck it, let's just take let's steal the presidency, Congress, and the Senate. Mm. Well, guess what? If they get away with this, woo, give them 4 years, fuck. What'll America look like in 4 years under that kind of rule?
Question I don't want to find out the answer to be honest.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, you look around at what's happening on the global basis, dictatorship is making a strong comeback.
Yeah.
Like I see in Germany, the videos of people are just like, hey, we want freedom. I got to tell you, I think there's going to be like a world uprising where people are going to take back their freedoms again. Like, I think we're going to see a massive world uprising where people are going to be like, listen, I'm going to fight for this freedom thing again. Thank God in America, we still got our Second Amendment.
Yeah.
But if those motherfuckers get the House, the Senate, and the presidency, you see that lunatic Biden, he wants to charge you a $200 a year tax on your gun.
I saw that.
Yeah, I'll say, hey, buddy, I'll pay mine in bullets. How's that?
I'll give that guy 6 months anyway before she's in.
That's the crazy thing. Like, he's like a pinch hitter. He's like, all right, we're swearing in Biden. Up, he's got to go. He's fucking mentally trashed.
Yep.
Here's the crazy thing too. Like, wherever he goes, his wife Jill is there, like almost like hand puppeting the guy. And I always think to myself, that's got to be a little embarrassing. Like, come on, Joe. Like, listen, just admit it. Your fucking brain is fried. If I'm 78. I don't want to be president. I'm stressing. I'd only want to be president for one day just so I can go to the press room and just rip those motherfuckers to shred. Jim Acosta, you got a question? No? Good, because I got one. How the fuck are you so bad at your job? Like, seriously, Jim. I'm like, who the fuck is paying all you guys to be such fucking terrible journalists? And then Biden, whenever he gets a question, Mr. Biden, what flavor ice cream did you get? What flavor ice cream? That's your question?
And somebody asked him a question about COVID or something. Why are you yelling at me? And went all crazy on the guy, and it's like,
oh, you got to follow. You got to check out Jerry Wayne. I'm gonna tag him in a tweet. He's the guy that was in the auto facility that asked Biden just a normal question about his gun policy, and Biden went crazy on him. And then Biden's like, yeah, I'm gonna take your AR-14s. Okay, it's AR-15, motherfucker.
Seriously.
And the NRA and Jerry made this video as funny as shit about AR-14s. It's AR-15, you lunatic. And then he's like, what do you need a 100-bullet clip? I'm like, they got a 100-bullet clip? I'm like, where do these guys get this shit? Maybe he's thinking about an AK-47. Maybe they got the 100-bullet clip.
I think you have to get into I don't know much about guns, but I think you'd have to get into a fairly high caliber before you could get like 100 bullets.
Well, I don't think people realize 100 bullets is pretty heavy. Like, your gun's going to be fucking weighed down. And you got to get that fucking thing to push the bullets up. So 100 bullets, you might be like, bang, bang, where's my bullets? That brings up another story. If you ever get a chance, do some research on this unbelievable cover-up in Las Vegas. There was a guy that, here's what people don't realize. Did you remember the guy that shot up a bunch of people supposedly in Las Vegas? 54 or 58 people died. So, what people never ask, they never ask this question. I don't know how they never ask this question. Literally the craziest thing I ever heard in my life. So in Vegas, in these beautiful resort casinos, they have these large windows. And I'm a fairly large guy, you know, pushing 250, 6'1". If I ran at top speed and I literally took my entire body weight and ran right towards the window, I would bounce off of it. They're that fucking strong. They're called hurricane proof or tornado proof or something like that. Mm-hmm. To open up the fucking windows, he had two of them that supposedly he shot out. He needed a drill, a long drill bit to drill into the base of the window. Okay. As soon as he drilled into it or even started drilling into it, a sensor would have gone off in the security office saying, yo, fucking window, man. Window seems to be breaking. Somebody might be jumping out the window. But this motherfucker has enough time to drill a hole in the base, take a sledgehammer, crack it open, and then go on the other room and do another window. Estimated time to do all that shit, 4 hours.
Damn.
Now, we're talking fucking a casino. Do you know how much security is in a fucking casino? They got cameras up your poop hole. They got cameras at the blackjack table. They got cameras in the elevator. They got cameras everywhere. We're supposed to believe that this motherfucker for 4 hours was drilling open two big fucking ass windows that have sensors in them, and security didn't go, yo, homie, what the fuck you doing in there?
Yeah, that's a good point, actually.
And nobody asked that question. The fucking CNN town hall guy, oh my God, all these people died. We should ban guns. Hey, motherfucker, why don't you ask about the windows? Now, the funny thing is, I was on the strip that day.
Oh.
And I have a video that I live streamed to Twitter. For whatever reason, I can never find it. Twitter somehow took it down. It's the craziest thing. But I have the video. And when I was at the Bellagio, which is not by the Mandalay Bay, it's up north, there were people and police came into the Bellagio, and they said at the north entrance, there were people shooting. My theory is, this was an FBI operation that went fucking shitball. Because here's another thing too. You know, he brought do you know what 400 pounds of bullets sounds, it smells like?
No.
I mean, think about that for a second. He had 400 pounds of bullets in the 34th floor suite of his room. He asked to use the freight elevator. If I fucking asked him, any casino, oh, by the way, could I use the freight elevator? I got some fucking luggage I want to bring up. No, the bellhop will get it for you. No, this is special stuff. Here's $100. Let me use the freight elevator. They'd be like, listen, go fuck yourself, buddy. But this guy gets the freight elevator. He goes up to the 34th floor. He's probably got a security guy in there with him. Do you know what fucking 400 pounds of bullets smells like? It smells like fucking 400 pounds of bullets. It smells like gunpowder and oil.
Probably rattles a bit too.
Rattles, yeah. Hey, what's that? Oh, just marbles. I got a bag full of peanuts. But this guy gets 400 pounds of bullets into his 34th chest. He's like, yeah, Dad, there's no fucking way that gets away. You get away with that. And supposedly, like, we're supposed to believe that that's common occurrence. I know. I can't believe it either.
Nope.
So nobody asked any of the right questions. And all of a sudden, that shit's fucking under the table. And by the way, all the lawsuits, all the investigation, you want to do a Freedom of Information Act? Good luck. The fucking sheriff department, the police captain here, Sheriff Lombardo. Mm-hmm. Holy fuck. It's unbelievable. Like, destroyed evidence, got disappeared evidence, can't get access to evidence. The lawsuit got paid off with $800 million trust fund. They got rid of that. They were like, yo, let's hide this thing before people ask the right questions.
Wow.
It all starts with, how do you break open those windows and security doesn't send somebody up to do a door check? Excuse me, sir, did you jump out the window?
Not going to get an answer.
Bet you this one's got your mind tinkering, huh? You'll be online looking. Las Vegas shooting.
I will not be typing any of that into Google, I can assure you.
What's your favorite browser? What's your favorite browser of choice?
I tend to use Brave or Opera. Opera has a built-in VPN.
Yeah, Brave. But Brave is basically Chrome without the app.
They're all pretty much Chrome, to be honest. It's difficult to find a browser that's not written in, I forget what it's called, WebKit. I guess Firefox is probably not, but it's, if you're going to type stuff like that into Google, you should probably not do that. You should probably use either VPN or VPN in your browser and VPN, or use something like DuckDuckGo, which is going to avoid the whole tracking you across the internet thing. So,
yeah, I think we're tracked anyhow. Like, ever since Edward Snowden released the Kraken and then told all of us about that information, I kept thinking to myself, they know everything. Like, hey, hey. Anybody listening to this, for the record, I never believed that fucking Vegas shooting shit at all. Well, surprised somebody's not knocking at my door right now. Excuse me, sir. We smell a chicken pot pie burning. No, don't worry about it. It's just slightly brown.
I didn't put the cheddar on yet, so.
I can't thank you enough for your time, man. This has been fun as hell. You got a great story to tell.
Thank you.
I'll be honest with you. There's a better book in your future, and I'm telling you, it has something to do with the lady in the toenails. And you can almost embellish it and make it like almost an adventure fiction type thing.
Good idea, actually.
If I were you, look at the movie Wanted. I think it raked in about $200-300 million. Start going along the line of Wanted.
Okay. Sounds good.
But have you enjoyed yourself?
I have, yes. Thank you. This has been a pleasure.
We've got a little digital content out there to tell your story. Send me your link to the book. Hopefully people will buy it. And by the way, I'm going to buy it just to read about the lady in the toenail. So if that's in the book, I can't even imagine what else is in the book.
Well, hopefully it's not the highlight.
I'll be honest with you. That is the highlight for me. I would, if you could just somehow have pictures in the book of her and your facial expression. Yeah, looks like there's toenails in there. What the fuck? Have you met anyone who finds that as funny as I do?
Not so far, but hopefully there will be more in the future.
Thomas, your son Max, right? His name's Max?
Yes. Yep.
You, Max, the wifey, have a great holiday. Hope the new crib has got a moat in it. I'll come visit you.
Good.
If it doesn't have a drawbridge and a moat, you've really not bought the right property. By the way, if COVID-21 is anything that I think it's going to be, 100% we're going to turn people into zombies.
Wouldn't be surprised, to be honest.
You know, they've got to reduce the population somehow. And everything, like, have you ever noticed, like, okay, so Star Trek, you remember Star Trek, right?
Yep.
So I don't know if you remember this, but the tricorder, remember, beat me up, Daddy? I don't know if you remember the first mobile phone. It was made by Motorola. Yeah. It was designed after Star Trek.
Yep.
So shit eventually comes full circle where it becomes reality. Well, I don't know if you've been aware of this, but there's been a shitload of fucking zombie movies the last like 20, 30 years. Like, did you ever see World War Z with Brad Pitt?
I read the book. I didn't see the movie yet.
Okay, you got to watch the movie. The movie's pretty damn good. Like, there's some intense scenes where people turn into zombies like real quick, and then they start chasing Brad Pitt and a group of other people that are not zombies. And you understand the real theory in life. You understand the real feeling in life of being in hot pursuit. They're like, feet don't fail me now. But I'm telling you, like, I keep thinking to myself, we've had 30 years of fucking zombie movies.
Yeah.
This shit is going to happen. Like, there's going to be a fucking issue where, and by the way, for the record, don't eat fucking bats in soup or otherwise. Somebody says, hey, Thanksgiving, we're having it at my house. We're having bat pot pie. Bat pot pie? The fuck's wrong with you people? Don't eat bats.
You'd think that would go without saying too, but
apparently. Yeah, like bat. Oh, you know, they think it came from bats. Who the fuck eats it? Here, think about this for a second. How much meat is on a bat? Have you ever seen a bat? They're like basically a mouse with big wings.
Yep.
If you ever went to Buffalo Wild Wings, hey, I want some fucking barbecue bat wings. How many do you want? 6,000? Yeah. What the fuck? Of course you're going to turn into a zombie. You ate a fucking bat.
Yeah.
And by the way, what is it with bats and weird shit anyhow? Like, all our lives, bats, vampires, vampires suck your blood. Eat bats in Wuhan. Oh, release the fucking Kraken of all viruses.
I don't know, to be honest. I try and stay as far away from bats as I can and anybody who eats them.
If you ever went to a restaurant and they gave you a bowl of bat soup, what would be your reaction?
Just get up and leave, to be honest.
And by the way, how do you know it's bat soup? Because the bat's wings are out to the side of the fucking bowl and there's a head popped up above the soup broth.
Exactly.
And the soup, the soup is basically a clam chowder type soup. Seriously, what do you do? You eat that thing with fucking chopsticks? Like, seriously, what the fuck?
To be honest, I've never given it any thought because I never considered the possibility.
Remember Anthony Bourdain?
Yes.
That motherfucker probably ate some bat soup. Hey, we're here in Adventures Beyond, and I'm here in Wuhan with my friend Sun Jun. We're going to have a bowl of bat soup. I've never had it before, but I hear it's tasty. I mean, and the funny thing is, when they started that whole bat soup story, I thought to myself, what? Like, we're going to lock down the economies because some fucking motherfuckers ate bat soup? Funny thing is, it's considered a delicacy. Like, the people in Wuhan, they have this market where you buy, like, I don't know, like bats and other shit.
Yeah.
And they were like fucking sad that they couldn't make bat soup. Like, it was like crazy. They're like, oh my God, you know how delicious that is? I'm like, it's a bat.
How do you even catch a bat? I mean, I just don't get it.
Can you imagine what the bats are thinking when they're in the cave and somebody's coming around with, like, you know, a bat net to try and catch them? Yeah, and they're like, there's that fucking crazy Wuhan soup guy. It's a fucking soup Nazi guy. Let's get the hell out of here. Can you imagine? You ever see Jerry Seinfeld?
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine a soup Nazi serving bat soup in New York City? No bat soup for you.
No soup for you. Thank you.
The soup Nazi in Wuhan, a Jerry Seinfeld special episode.
Oh, now you have a book too.
Huh?
And now you have a book fiction that you can write.
You want to hear something funny? I was in New York. I've actually gone to the Soup Nazis place. I've actually gone to, that's a real place.
Yep, me too.
And it's pretty fucking wild. Like, it's literally spot on.
Yep.
You have to wait outside. You have to go in one. He's like very organized about it. I will tell you one thing. He gives you a lot of motherfucking soup.
And it's like, delicious.
Yeah, when you get out of there, he gives you like this big fucking like ice cream container of soup. I'm like, best $15 I ever spent.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's you gotta love like Jerry Seinfeld. Wow, what a run they had.
Yeah.
Perfect cast to them, by the way.
Yep.
George carried his role well. Elaine, Jerry.
Yeah, George was in Criminal Minds.
Was he?
Yeah, he played a villain in one of the episodes.
I did not know that. You know who I thought was going to have a big career after Seinfeld, but it just never took off? Fucking Michael. What was his name?
Kramer?
Kramer.
Yeah.
His real name, I think, is Michael something, isn't it?
I think it's Michael Kramer. I always thought it was Michael Kramer.
No, I don't
to be honest.
I definitely know it's not Michael Kramer. Like that, I'm sure. His character was Kramer. What the hell was his name on the show?
Michael
Richards. But what was his name on the show? Was it always just Kramer? Did anyone ever figure out if he had like a full name? Like, was Kramer his first or his last name?
I think they might have done an episode about it, but I don't remember.
Yeah, but I got to look that one up one day. How funny was that guy? Can you imagine? I would never move if he was my next door neighbor. Like I'd live there just to fucking see the shit he does every day.
They don't have it on Wikipedia, so I can't answer the question.
Yeah, Wikipedia is like the go-to source for actual information these days. It's amazing the shit that Wikipedia puts up there. Like there's people that manipulate Wikipedia to like if it's amazing like how they can like become such a trusted source yet have such manipulated data.
Yeah. But for quick reference type stuff like this, it's fairly easy. But I wouldn't rely on it for a
project that's trying to compete with Wikipedia. It's called they raised like $30 million through can't remember the name. Mohammed, some kid was the founder, I think. Exipedia or something with an E.
Okay.
You find it?
No, it's trying to give me all the Wikipedia articles on cryptography or cryptocurrency.
Yeah, it's. I'll send it to you if I find it, but it's interesting. It's an interesting project. Because I always thought that Wikipedia type project was good for a decentralized project. That makes sense.
Decentralized. Everpedia.
Everpedia. There you go.
Yeah.
I knew it was with an E. It's an interesting project.
That is cool. And they have their own token.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I think that was just, a way to just siphon money into the project.
Sure.
I don't see where there's a token what do I need a token? I don't know. Just, there's some token projects when they like went out and sold it and raised $30 million. I thought to myself, what the fuck did you guys just buy? Do you have any clue? Like a girl the other day wanted to argue with me in one of my paid groups about cryptocurrencies. She's like, I thought you knew your shit. Well, how come you didn't tell us about, Ripple? I'm like, because Ripple sucks. No, Ripple's awesome. I said, tell me what Ripple does. Ripple, it's just like Bitcoin. Not even close.
Nope. Yeah, anybody, or I guess most people cannot explain what Ripple does.
So. Well, here's the crazy thing. For as much as you take shots at Ripple, those motherfuckers go into banks who have like really conservative motherfucking think tanks and they sell billions of that fucking shit. And it, for all I can tell, it has no use case whatsoever.
I bought some in 2017, I think early part of 2017, and I sold it at 253. So, excuse me, I think it went up to like $3 or something, but that was my only involvement with Ripple ever.
Here's the crazy thing. It's centralized too. Like if you want to send Ripple and they could actually reverse the transaction.
Yeah.
Like I always think to myself, it's not a cryptocurrency. Just some digital shit that they want to call crypto.
Yeah, it's basically a transfer token.
Now,
I understand it.
You know Jed McCallum?
I've heard the name. I don't know him.
One of the oldest guys in crypto. He sells, I shit you not, this is the craziest thing. He sells like $1 million worth of Ripple a day. He's got that much Ripple and he sells it every day.
Wow.
Yeah, he's literally trying to, you know, obviously unload the shit. But if you ever look him up, Google him, Jed, founder of Ripple. He was one of the co-founders and they had to split it. They had a, you know, they split up and, you know, the Ripple guy, Brad Gerlinghouse, kept going down the Ripple path. And Jed said, hey, just give me like a trillion Ripple. I think he ended up with like a trillion Ripple. And he's like slowly getting rid of his Ripple. But he sells like $1 million a day. I think to myself, who the fuck buys $1 million worth of Ripple a day? Like, I get the easy part is selling it. The hard part is who the fuck is on the other end?
Yeah.
And it turns out it's bankers and idiot girls in fucking Michigan. By the way, I don't mean how come you didn't tell me about Ripple? Because it sucks. Oh, yeah, it went up.
I said, well, we all know. That's what cryptocurrency does. Goes up.
It's funny. You look at, you know, Dave Portnoy, the founder of Barstool.
Yep.
He bought Bitcoin. Then he sold it. He was I sold it. Somebody keeps track of what his Bitcoin would be worth the other day on some site. And it's like, oh, Dave, your Bitcoin would be worth like $300,000. He's like, fuck off. Today on Thanksgiving, he's like, the Thanksgiving Day Massacre. He posts the fucking slaughtering of Bitcoin on there.
Yeah, it's happened before. It'll happen again. But
yeah, I mean,
in the long run.
I always tell people, don't buy Bitcoin for the price. Buy Bitcoin because you're hedging against idiot politicians, which, by the way, it's the greatest hedge in the world because you can't lose. Politicians aren't idiots. They will always be idiots and they should never be in charge of economic decisions.
Exactly.
But they are. We elect them and then, oh yeah, we're going to make this decision. We're gonna print $1 trillion. Oh really? Does that have any negative side effects?
Oh no, not at all. 22% of all.
The funniest thing too is Trump didn't sign off on the $4 trillion or whatever ridiculous stimulus package the Democrats wanted. But if somehow they get this little scam done that they're working on and Biden gets into office, mark my words, those motherfuckers are going to print money. I'm not kidding you. They're going to do in 2021 alone, probably $10 trillion in stimulus.
Yep.
You know, universal basic income, free healthcare, let everybody across the border. Fucking give away free money to all the arts, pay off everyone's student loan. How much? We got anything left? No? Okay. And I love the whole concept. Why am I as a taxpayer excited about paying off somebody's student loans? Like, that whole argument is the most insane thing I've ever heard. But if they do want to do it, I instantly want to go borrow some fucking money to go back to school.
Pretty much.
Yeah. And here's the crazy thing. What about all those poor people that borrowed money to go to school and paid it back?
Well, that was the thing. Somebody asked, how's her name? Elizabeth Warren. He's like, well, if you're going to pay people student loans back, what about the one I already paid off for my daughter? Am I going to get that money back?
Oh, that was in Iowa. I actually saw that.
Yeah. She turned around and goes, no, why would you? It's like, well, this is the thing you're not thinking about, lady. You're not taking it to its logical conclusion. You're paying off all these loans for all these people who have them now, but what about the people who are good and paid off their loans already? So it's the second order consequences they can never get to. That's the thing that they never think about. They're like, oh yeah, okay, these people are suffering. Well, how can we alleviate their suffering? Well, what happens when you do that? That's the next step they never take. And that's the most irritating part, I think, about all of that.
The only reason I would ever want to admit that I'm a Democrat is so that I could actually get onto the Death Star before they blow up.
Yeah, I mean, that
Bezos would be the only... is sitting there with his iPad going, are you a Democrat? Yes, I am. All right, go on, get in. You'll get your, what's the white outfit that the, what were the white guys, the guys, what were they? They weren't called Centurions. What were the?
Oh, the Stormtroopers?
Stormtrooper. Your Stormtrooper outfit is on the size. I'm like, all right, fuck, I'm a Stormtrooper. I'm a Stormtrooper and I'm on the Death Star. How bad could this be? Elon Musk, please save me. Let's get to fucking Mars.
Yes, that would be nice.
Elon Musk get to Mars before he dies?
Oh, yeah. There's no stopping that guy.
I'll be honest with you. He's making so many trips up to outer space with his rockets now that the space station has got to be booming. Like, they've got to be, they got to have like a club up there now where they're just partying. See fucking Elon, you know, people are like weightless dancing. Woo! Elon's got like some massive fucking bong that's floating around. Hey, take a hit.
Well, he's the second richest person on Earth, and SpaceX is not even a public company. So,
oh, they're not. Imagine.
No,
private.
It's only Tesla. Yeah, SpaceX is private. So
there's a reason probably for that. You know that, right?
Yeah, government contracts and competition with all the government contractors. So, but yeah, it's quite interesting because
okay, so all of that. One thing we haven't touched upon that I got to ask you: aliens, do they exist?
Probably, but
okay, I'm gonna save you some time. 100 motherfucking percent. 100 motherfucking percent.
Question of them getting here or us finding them, I think, is the
well, they already got here because the Department of Defense released earlier this year, when nobody was paying attention, gobs of fucking data that says a ship not made of this earth landed here. And I'll be honest, I think it was right here in Vegas, Area 51. Like when some kids thought it would be a fun joke to have like a rave out by Area 51, the government shut it down real quick. They're like, listen, if you come anywhere closer, we will shoot you.
Yeah, the storm Area 51 thing.
Yeah, that didn't play out so well. So my thinking is they're obviously pretty serious about keeping the place hidden.
Yeah. I could see that.
And I saw, what was the 4th of July movie where Will Smith went to Area 51?
Yep, 4th of July, or Independence Day.
Yeah, it's not too far of a reach, right? I mean, movies True. Do somehow have some sort of connectivity to reality.
Well, that's the best part when the grandfather gets on the president's plane and he's like, you've known about this for years, Area 51. The president's like, no, that's ridiculous. And then the secretary guy's like, well.
Yeah. You know that secretary guy is like either Nancy Pelosi or fucking Chuck Schumer. And when the world is going to shit one day, they have to go like, okay, so we probably should have told you this, but between us and the CIA and the deep state, we were hoping to keep it a secret. We've got these fucking aliens. They're in this fucking prison. We can't get them to talk. 100% there's aliens. 100%. And here's the other thing. Why all of a sudden do we need a military arm in space? Aliens?
I don't know.
It's fucking aliens. 100%. If they didn't think that there were aliens, they wouldn't. And here's the other thing, too. This military force, when you go into outer space and you shoot a handgun, the bullet's not going to come out. It's not going to shoot.
Shouldn't even fire.
Well, the hammer will hit the end of the bullet, and that will create at least an explosion. And maybe the bullet goes out a little bit, but I don't think it does what it's supposed to. I don't think you shoot a 9mm in space. I'm almost sure they need their own weaponry.
It needs oxygen to fire, I thought. So. If you're inside a space station where there's oxygen, it'll fire. But if you're firing outside.
That is true. It does need oxygen to fire. So, yeah, I guess all it would do would just strike, and that's it. The hammer would just strike.
Yeah.
like a cartoon. And you see, like, a little bullet slowly coming out.
Yeah.
And then in outer space, somebody can go, let me move it a little bit. Move the projectile. You ever see that? I want to say the Marvel Comics, the Avengers, or not the Avengers, but
X-Men.
Where the kid was super fast, and then he's literally like moving bullets around. Man, that kid was bomb. I think they were like trying to make him the Silver Surfer, or no, I don't think he was the Silver Surfer, but he was basically what's his name's son, Magneto's son.
Magneto's son, yeah. Quicksilver.
Is Quicksilver.
Yeah,
and he had like the best role in that one scene where he's like just. Running so fast, which, by the way, if I ever get that superpower and I go to the craps table in Vegas, I am rolling the most heart eights ever in the history of mankind.
You'd have to lose occasionally or else they'd figure it out.
Oh, yeah. Listen, let me tell you something. Vegas is not ever going to let you win that much money.
Right.
They'd be like, listen, buddy, we got to talk to you. We got a VIP room we want you to go upstairs and talk to. Yeah, I'm almost sure. I'm almost sure the day I ever get super lucky in Vegas, they stop me like right in the middle of the whole thing and say, can we talk for a second? I'll be like, why? I'm on a heater. Get away from me, dog. Yeah, Quicksilver could never play craps at the casino.
Nope.
That and roulette. Sir, you've hit roulette 7 times in a row. I am so fucking lucky.
The odds of that are approximately 1 in 2,400 trillion.
Okay, funny gambling story. One night, I'm not even paying attention. Well, my birthday is on the 26th. And I'm sitting there talking to this ridiculously hot, probably hooker, but she was fun to talk to. And the way roulette is, there's like 6 tables in an area, and you can see all the numbers that have been played. And out of nowhere, while she's talking, and I'm thinking about her breasts, I look around and I can never see, I look on all the tote boards and I just don't see 26. Like, it just dawned on me. I'm like, no table has hit 26. So just for shits and giggles, I put $200 on 26, period. And I lost. But I did it again. And I lost again. And then I did it another time just for shits and giggles. And I'm looking at the girl's tits for a while. And all of a sudden, the fucking guy puts the little clear thing on top of my hand. And everybody's losing their shit. $7,000.
Wow.
Yeah. I had to explain to the hooker that I wasn't giving her any money, but it was exciting for me. She's like, oh my God, we can have some fun. I'm like, actually, not really. I'm just going to keep this money.
I'm going to go over here and you're going to go over there and have a nice evening.
Well, it didn't quite work out. Like, what do you mean? I'm like, listen, as much as I'd like to, you and I both know that you want most of this and I want most of it too.
That just doesn't work.
Have you been to Vegas?
Yes, several times. It's great. It's
not great anymore.
A little hot.
No shows, no entertainment, very little free.
Yeah, I guess I really hadn't thought about that, to be honest.
Here's the crazy thing, too. Like, you'll be out there, you'll wear your fucking idiot mask. Your mask slips below your nose. Mm-hmm. Fucking, I'm not kidding you. Security comes out of nowhere, taps you on the shoulder. Sorry, above the nose. We got little sticks of tape if you want tape. Get the fuck away from me. Like, they literally come out of everywhere. Like, if that shit goes below your nose a little bit, they're just tapping. Sir, could you get it over your nose? Over your nose. Wow. Dude, you know how fucking annoying that is? The whole mask thing, I'm almost sure, is a social experiment on social obedience.
Could well be.
Because the masks don't protect you that much.
No, it largely depends, I suppose, because... quite frankly, I think most people probably, A, don't wear them correctly, even if they wanted to, and B, don't make them correctly. So,
well, here's the crazy thing. I know so many people that keep their fucking masks in their car, in their ashtray of their car, in their hood visor of their car, wear them for months on end. And supposedly, when you get out of your car in order to just enter facilities, this mask that has been literally sitting in your ashtray is now supposed to protect you from what?
Yeah,
but it's a social experiment. And they're like, oh, okay, this motherfucker wears the mask, so he's easily convinced on anything we tell him. And this cocksucker, he won't even wear the mask and hates the mask, so we got to make sure we take away his guns or charge him $200 a year in taxes.
Yeah, that's crazy. That tax will be...
So we've had a crazy 2021 or 2020. Is 2021 crazier?
Probably.
I think so.
It's going to get crazier before it gets less crazy. So
the sad thing that I'm starting to see is in the UK especially, you're seeing less aid go to Africa. And it brings me back to that whole TED talk with Billy Gates, where he's like, hey, we just got to reduce the size of the planet. I think the first place that they're reducing the size is in Africa. People are just going to die on there.
Yeah, I haven't seen that talk, so it's something I'm going to have to watch.
Yeah, it's basically Bill Gates talking about just reducing the population, that it's too big, the planet can't support it, blah, blah, blah.
Well, I mean, we went
great reset story.
No, I was gonna say we went from like 1 billion beginning of this century to 7.5 billion now. So,
yeah, there's a lot of people, most of them in China.
A third of the population of Earth lives in China and India. So,
is that what, a third?
Yeah,
I gotta be honest with you, I've been to India a couple of times, I love the Indian people, but that fucking country has got the worst cleanliness. Like, they have no sewage system, their water system is fucked, and their air pollution is off the hook.
Wow.
Yeah.
I've never been there.
You got to go. Just to see it, you'll never believe it in your million. Like, I would wake up in the mornings, and there was so much soot that the clouds would actually be weighed down at night. And then they would go up in the morning and the soot would be on the sidewalks and the side of the buildings. And they would literally use hoses to wash down the soot. Well, guess what? When you wash it down, it turns into this kludgy fucking mud and there's no fucking sewers. They literally didn't build a sewage and water system when they built India. They didn't think about like, okay, where do we put all the poop and pee and where do we get the actual clean water from? Yeah, it's a tough situation. They have, and they're the most amazing people in the world, and they're super smart. But sewage and water wasn't like one of their, let's plan for this shit. They would be better off literally going block by block or city by city and saying, listen, everybody move down the street for like a year, and we're going to start building out the infrastructure we need to, you know, just build forward. And they would be better off just making sure they had fucking the sewage system. They don't have a sewage system. It's the worst.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
It's crazy. For as smart as they are, sewage and water should have been one of those things they should have fixed by now.
Yeah. I sort of just presume you take that for granted and that it would always be everywhere.
It's one of those things you got to plan for.
Well, yeah.
When you're planning a country, all right, poop and pee, what do we do with it? Folks, I need an idea here. And by the way, where's the water for my shower coming from? And is it clean? Like when you buy the house with the moat, what do we do with the poop and the pee?
We need separate water source from the moat for everything else.
Do not ship the poop and the pee into the moat. The fucking alligators are going to die.
Although, technically be very effective moat then, I suppose.
By the way, if you get a chance, Google alligator in Florida dinosaur. There is an alligator in Florida. It's the fucking SUV of alligator. It's the Hummer. It's a military vehicle of an alligator. It is unbelievably large in size. Like, it's literally, it's got to be prehistoric. Like, this thing is unbelievable in size. Have you seen it?
No.
I'm not kidding you. If you get a chance, Google this thing. Actually, you know what? I know YouTube's going to censor the fuck out of this video, but we're doing this.
To plug in my Mac, or I'm going to go to sleep.
Oh, we've been on that long.
What the hell is going on here? Why is it popping up this warning?
Gator, Florida, dinosaur. Let's see if I can find it. Oh my God, the first thing. Okay, here, I gotta show you this. This, I'm like, I'm not kidding you. You're never gonna believe this. First of all, I got a big dog. Jesse's a pretty big dog. If Jesse saw this.
I bet you can't guess what it is.
Oh my God.
This.
Could it be a bike?
I knew it.
Okay, by the way, literally she's the worst actress ever. So you know.
They're calling this beast Godzilla.
Do you see that thing?
Have you guys seen this?
Wow.
A giant gator. Look at this. Oh, it almost looks like a joke.
Lots of people on social media assume the video was a fake, but it's not. Can you imagine coming face to face with this creature?
What the fuck?
For a stroll.
That's crazy.
The video was taken by a pro golfer at the Valencia Country Club in Naples, Florida. When he posted the video of the alligator online, it went viral in a flash. That giant looks like a baby dinosaur, goes one comment. And this, I just moved here yesterday. Pretty sure I can get my deposit back. One major reason why the gator looks so menacing is that he's doing a so-called high walk. Usually, when we see gators on the move, they're much closer to the ground.
Well, that's because they're smaller like that.
The reason it gets in a high walk is really because it's faster walking that way.
Zoo Miami wildlife expert Ron McGill.
I don't care what this guy's saying. That's a big alligator. I don't care how he's fucking walking.
Think about yourself. Just doing a push-up is not easy, okay? So think about walking that way on all fours. When an alligator's body is so much larger than its small legs.
Yeah. Look at this.
I don't care how that fucking alligator is walking. It's humongous. By the way, this is the same alligator, I'm almost sure.
That is the biggest freaking alligator I have ever seen in my life.
Like, what if that fucker turns around and just starts running at you? I think that motherfucking thing could outrun me.
Yeah, probably. Probably outrun all of us.
Look at that fucking thing. I've never seen anything that
big. It's like the size of the sand trap. It's crazy.
I was just going to say, it's like the fucking size of the sand trap almost. Look at this guy. I actually want the alligator to eat him.
Get next to it for perspective.
I want him to eat him.
Get next to it for perspective, he says.
Yeah, exactly. Lay next to it. See what it does.
Here is the perspective of getting eaten.
I'm almost sure this is the same alligator that was spotted in the other video.
That's crazy.
It is a monster.
There's another recent video where a Florida man, and of course the Florida man meme, but he basically saves a small dog from a baby alligator.
And oh, I saw that. You know what the most epic thing about that was? He kept that cigar in his mouth.
But I mean, you can see he's trying to pry the alligator, and like the force that the alligator has, even as a baby, full grown man struggles with it. And
by the way, that's an unwritten rule. If an alligator gets your dog, you got to go and get your dog back because your dog would go and get you back.
Yep.
It's the unwritten rule. Like if Jesse was, most incredible thing about that whole thing is what nobody realizes, the alligator had the dog under the water and the guy went under the water, grabbed the alligator, brought the dog back, which by the way, the dog was a little puppy. He was like, as soon as he got free, he was like, ah, dad! He's like, do not fucking go near the alligator puppy.
Do not go near the alligator people.
I don't see these pulling 80 pounds. Oh, shit. This is way more than.
Get near him for perspective. Look, if you saw this fucking thing, would you get near it?
No.
Like, what people don't realize is if that fucker wanted to snap and turn and start running at you,
I think that's two guys in an alligator
suit. He could probably easily catch a human being. Yep. Even at this distance, I swear I would love to see that alligator right now just snap and turn.
I mean, these things have existed on Earth for 350 million years. They've survived literally the thing that killed the dinosaurs. So
I think this guy might have killed dinosaurs.
That is enormous.
I know. Look at this. It's definitely the same one in the other video.
Yeah.
What blows my mind is that somebody hasn't somehow like tagged this thing to just see where he goes and what he does. And by the way, how old do you think that thing is?
Probably several decades.
Gotta be. It's gotta be like 40, 50 years old.
Yeah.
Holy mother of God!
I'm going to get my camera. But
look at the deer. Look at that deer in the background.
They're like, we are not moving a muscle.
The deer are like,
yeah, that's about it.
If he comes towards us, we're out of here. Look at the baby deer. Mom, what is that?
Yeah. That son is death. That's crazy.
He's got some fucked up elbow arm there. He's like, my elbow's a little dry. Look at Jesus, what the hell? Look at that thing. Even the deer are like intimidated.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, that's
that deer's kind of like a little underfed there. He looks a little thin. Look at this. Look at that. That is holy mother of, oh my God. And then here's the zoo. Oh, yeah, it's like he's doing push-ups, buddy. Heck, this is a big alligator. Wow, we turned this talk into a fucking alligator.
That's a Mandalorian.
Yeah, have you seen it? Is it any good?
Like and subscribe
right
now.
I liked it, actually.
Oh, you're not going to like and subscribe.
By the reserve's head ranger, a hippo that was clearly
Those things will...
Hippo and a rhino.
Kill you, too.
Who wins that fight, the hippo or the rhino?
In over
its probably head, the rhino.
He's seen trying its luck with a group of rhinos. The area surrounding the airstrip was all...
Yeah, he's trying to eat their poo. I'll tell you what. Hippos are just stupid animals. Tom, have you had a good time? Has it been fun?
I have. Yes, thank you.
All right, so at least you got something to show Max somewhere down the road. Max probably will see this tomorrow, right? He'll be like, Dad, I Googled your name on YouTube. You were talking about alligators.
Alligators.
Yeah. I'll be honest with you. If you don't show Max the alligator videos tomorrow, I'll be shocked. Like when Max sees that alligator, he'll be like, Dad, what the fuck is that?
I'll have to tell them they're only in Florida, though. So,
but we're getting one for the new house. We're putting in a moat. 100%. You buy a house with a moat and a drawbridge, and you put that alligator in there. No zombies. You're zombie proof, honey. The alligator ate 12 more zombies. 100% when zombies hit, that alligator lives all the way through.
It'd be even bigger by the time the thing's done. So.
That alligator, he's literally, I'm almost sure he literally has, I have zero fucks to give on his mind.
Yeah. There is nothing on earth that can touch that thing, to be honest.
Like people take pictures, the deer watch him walk by, and in his mind, he's laughing his ass off, go, I got zero fucks to give, and I'm just looking for a beer.
Yep.
God, I can imagine like the little old lady that runs through that thing. Have you seen my little dog? Lady, did you see the fucking alligator walking through the hood? Just assume at this point it's time to say goodbye to the puppy.
Yes, that was not even a snack for the alligator.
I actually love that old guy. Funny thing, he's got a cigar in the mouth the whole time. Grabs the alligator and the puppy under the water. They're under the water already. So the puppy didn't even drown. Pulls him out. Puppy's like, and the alligator, and he's literally, I'll be honest with you, I think that even then that had to be fucking tough as hell.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Those things have a bite force that's unbelievable. And you can see he's not a weak guy by any stretch of the imagination. He's struggling. Now, obviously, the thing has razor sharp teeth inside, so that's probably not making it any easier. But at the same time, this is a baby alligator, so something like that is going to be just ridiculous.
Well, here's the crazy thing. I wish they would have kept shooting the video, because I kept thinking to myself, okay, the puppy's free to safety. He's now sitting there.
With an alligator in his hands.
On top of an alligator. And he's wet and you got no fucking traction. I'm thinking to myself, what was his next move? Because the alligator was like, fuck, motherfucker, I was hungry. You took away the puppy. I guess I'm eating you. At least give me an ankle.
Yeah. Or some fingers or something.
The only thing I can think of is if I'm that guy, I take the alligator, keep his mouth closed, and I pick him up and I toss him in the water and I hope that I've got enough distance to run.
Yeah. Or do your best to get out first, then toss him and run. But
and the funny thing is, he's got like boat shoes on, which are the worst gripping shoes on the planet. Like, if you had to run from an alligator, you're probably like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Well, we've covered it all. We've covered your book. We've covered fingernails and the keyboard. We've covered alligators, Max, the new moat, the house. I can't tell you. I appreciate your time. It's been a blast. Likewise. Love the story. There's always a story to be told, and you did not disappoint.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Sometime, maybe when the
absolutely.
Next out, maybe when you buy the house with the moat.
Okay.
Dude, if you get that fucking alligator in the moat, it'll be
indeed.
People in London will be like, why'd you ship them up from Florida? When the zombies come, my house will be protected.
Yep.
Cool. Tom, it's been late. You had to get some juice in your laptop just to keep going. I thank you a ton for your time, brother.
Likewise. Thank you.
Send me the links to where people can buy the book, where they can find you. We'll put the links here. Follow him, learn from him. He is an interesting character. At the very least, you now have something to ask him on Twitter.
Absolutely.
All right. Peace out.
Thank you very much.
Have a happy holiday.
You too. Happy Thanksgiving.